Hey kids, this is Misty with Kids Connect, and I just want to say hi again. Haven't seen you in so long. It feels like forever. Can't wait to see you and hold you, give you hugs and kisses. But until then, we're just gonna have to enjoy the videos. So today we're gonna continue our series on No Fear. I feel like that's where we're at in society, is that we have to constantly fight fear. And so many times in the Bible, it says, do not be afraid or do not fear. And if the Bible says it, there's something that God will give us so that we, and that's peace in our heart, and which we talked about last time. But today we're going to talk about Matthew 14, 22 and 20 through 33, where Peter walked on water. And this story is so significant, I feel like, during this time, because there was such a faith when Peter stepped out of the boat to walk on water. All he saw was Jesus, and he was looking straight at Jesus, and he said, can I come? And he said, yes. And then he got out of the boat, which is a big step of faith to get out of a boat on water. That's amazing. And then he began to walk. Well, the storms were raging at that time, maybe not heavy, but they were still raging. And he began to take his eyes off Jesus and onto the storm. And when he took his eyes off Jesus and onto the storm, what happened? He began to sink. But there was the good news, and this is the part that we have to know. When we're right now, if you have your eyes on the storm of this coronavirus, and you're sinking and you're in fear, what do you need to do? Just what the story is. Take your eyes off the storm. Take your eyes off the problem. Yes, we have to use wisdom. Yes, we have to use be wise in when we're going out in public. But what do we have to do? We have to refocus on Jesus. Because when Peter refocused on Jesus, guess what? Jesus lifted him right up with no problems. He lifted him right up, and then they walked back, and the storm no longer was so evident because he was focused on Jesus. And that's what I want you to do this week, is find places you're not focusing on Jesus. Find places that you're in fear. Because, you know, we have a stance, no fear. We do not want to walk in fear. We do not want to walk, and we want to walk in faith, because that's what Jesus wants us to do. And he gives us all the tools we need. And I really believe it's real simple. We change our focus. When Peter changed his focus from Jesus, or from the storm to Jesus, he was able to walk again on water and was not affected by the storm. And right now it is so difficult, because we see the news, we see everywhere we go, people are in face masks, and you're no longer allowed to go to restaurants. So it's in our face all day long. And so, but what we have to do is, before we go anywhere, kids, just pray for your parents and pray for yourself, and just thank the Lord that he's protected us, because we know what? We have the authority. Remember, we've been learning about authority before this came. And authority is like when your parents tell you to do something, you know you have to do it. Parents have the authority to tell you. Just like our governors have the authority to shut down the restaurants and different things like that. But ultimately, we know that we get our authority in Jesus, because the devil's under our feet. And we don't have to walk in fear, because we know by the blood of Jesus that we have the authority to command the coronavirus and command the things to leave our homes and not touch us until it has to die. Because the Bible says that no plague will come nigh our dwelling. That means the coronavirus is a plague. And we just have to speak the name of Jesus and his authority and the name of Jesus. And every time we go out, just plead the blood of Jesus over us and walk out in faith, knowing that we're protected. And there's one other thing I want to do, and I hope you've been saying your prayers at night, the nighttime prayers. And I'm going to pray over you, and I'm going to bless you. And before I do that, I want to pray for our president and his staff and all the people that they can, and all of our governors, that they can make wise decisions so that we can get back to work and that we can get back to our normal lives, our normal. And I don't believe we're going to have a new normal. I believe it's going to go normal. Other than maybe the things that we can take away is that we need to spend more time with our family. So let me pray over you guys. And I want you to make this very personal for yourself. You can say this. And this is the easy to read version. So of Numbers 6, 22 through 26. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord smile down on you and show you his kindness. May the Lord answer your prayers and give you peace. And just know, remember, I'm going to go ahead and do it so you can repeat after me so that you can say it for yourself. May the Lord bless me and keep me. May the Lord smile down on me and show me his kindness. May the Lord answer my prayers and give me peace. And that's the thing we have to focus on, is his peace.